don't be tempted. When you are given a little trust, don't abuse it. By not abusing it, you will get bigger trust. That's it. Number two, don't mock God. Don't say, don't try to be what you are not. Whatever man sows, that's what he reaps. Finally, the other day I was watching these TVs, CNN actually, and there was a big program there about your breakfast. I don't know whether you watched it. There is this woman called Amanpour. He was interviewing a man who has written a book about our prayer breakfast. This man, I think he's linked with the other groups. You remember the other groups? I think he's linked with the homosexuals. He has written a book called The Family or something like that, saying that we who are involved in the prayer breakfast movement are like a secret society, that we are led by Doug Coe, if you know Doug Coe, our chairman, who died recently, that we are led by Doug Coe, and that we meet secretly, and we plan how to take over governments and stay in power. It's really amazing. So I think anybody who knows this fellow, could invite him when he comes here. And they were of course talking about Uganda also, that there is a very strong branch of this prayer breakfast movement in Uganda, and that it has got terrible people like a man called David Bahati. There's a man called David Bahati who said that homosexuals should be killed. Oh, can you imagine, this man said homosexuals should be killed? But I want really to, because of me, I'm a product of Africa. Whatever I do is Afrocentric, Afrocentric. The reason I linked up with the Doug Coe and I brought this movement here was because they were doing what some of our people had neglected doing, which the NRM have done. So I often recall Doug Coe, a member of NRM, although he never bought a card or wanted to join. But what he was doing was exactly what the NRM had been doing. And that's how I linked up with him. First of all, the movement did not emphasize the interdenominational rivalries. That's what I saw. Did not emphasize, I am Catholic, I am Protestant, I am Muslim, I am... No, they said, focus on God. Do you believe in God? If you do, doesn't matter what denomination you belong to, you are welcome. That's what I saw there. But I also, he briefed me how it started in 1953, when the situation in the world was very dangerous, the rivalry between the Soviet Union and the West, and how they would meet, even the people from the other side. So there was also the issue of reconciliation of inter-civilizational dialogue. That is the second point I saw. Number one, interdenominational, but focusing mainly on God, without emphasizing the denominations. Number two, inter-civilizational linkages. That's what I saw in this movement. So if there's anything I don't know, but you should tell me. If this a civil society you're organizing, you should tell me. Otherwise, if what I saw is what is, let's really move out boldly, because you heard what the preacher said. How can you light a lamp and you put it under a bushel? The Nyakwera one is terrible. No hembe tetara okajumichile chivo. In the Nyakwera it is terrible. How can you have a lamp and you cover it? You should put it on a lamp stand so that it shines everybody. This, so that the people see the light, see your good deeds, and praise your Father who is in heaven. We should not really be ashamed. I was really amazed by that group, and I wish we could come here and we have dialogue with them. If you know where they are, bring them and we enlighten them. So I thank the preacher. I encourage him to write his message in a booklet, so that it can be easily accessed. And I thank you for coming in such big numbers. And I want to apologize for coming a little bit late, but God knows everybody's at least where we have come. Thank you, may God bless you.
Let's put our hands together once again to appreciate Your Excellency the President for the powerful message from God that You have given us. May take our seats.